Hi! I can tell by the comments on my laser videos that many of you are confused on what a watt is, especially for lasers, and for good reason. Look at these two, for example. One is an LED lamp advertised as a 5.7 watt equal to 40 watts. The other is a laser advertised as a 20 watt equal to 4.5 to 5 watts. Say what now? Isn't a watt or what? Well, in this video, I'll explain the differences and show why a 5-watt laser is a completely different beast than a 5-watt LED. This video will feature my strongest laser ever. At this power level, you need to wear laser safety glasses at any time the laser is plugged in. Be prepared for random laser-induced fires and use ventilation to vent the nasty chemicals coming from whatever the laser beam obliterates. First off, in physics, a watt is always a watt. It is a unit of power, a quantity for the rate of energy transfer. So why is a half-watt laser high risk and exciting to me, while a 5-watt LED lamp is eye safe and mundane? The confusion is caused by the fact that energy comes in many forms. For the LED lamp, the listed wattage is the input of electrical power. This lamp uses 5.7 watts of electrical power to generate light. Easy to measure with a power meter. 5.6 watts. Close enough. Its amount of light output is similar to an old-fashioned, less efficient incandescent lamp that uses 40 watts of electrical power. All of this is hopefully common knowledge. It just doesn't apply to lasers. For lasers, it is usually the output of optical power that is listed, a measure of the power of the light coming from the laser, not how much electricity it uses to generate the light. However, to add to the confusion, it is now common for laser engravers to list the input of electrical power to the laser. Let me demonstrate using this laser engraver slash cutter. On the label, it says maximum luminous power 5500 milliwatts. Strictly speaking, it should say max optical power. More on lumens later. Anyway, 5500 milliwatts is equal to 5.5 watts. Let's test on my laser power meter how strong it really is. First, I set the laser power meter to match the laser's wavelength, around 450 nanometers, for best calibration. For aiming the laser, I use the focus function in the laser gerbil program. This will turn the laser on at only 3% of max power, making it much safer to set up. It will also give us the first indication of the laser's power output. Okay, the power meter measures max 66.6 milliwatts. That's disturbing. I mean, if this is 3% of max power will be around 2.2 watts. That's a lot, but less than half of the advertised output. I will go straight to the full power test. Are you ready for it? Holy hallelujah! Don't go into this light. It stabilizes at 5.7 watts, above all specifications and my expectations. Ignore the max reading of 16 watts. That's a bug in the laser power meter. 5700 milliwatts from a single laser diode. Not only is this the strongest diode I have ever measured, it is almost 4 times as strong as second place, or well over 1,000 times more than the limit where laser safety goggles are needed. Alright, back to the difference. For the LED, the wattage is electrical power input. For the laser, it is optical power output. The laser does have an electrical power input too, around 20 watts, while the LED also has an optical power output. Warm white LEDs are not as efficient as cool white LEDs. This one probably has an optical power output of around 1.2 watts. Now, hold on. 1.2 watts would still be a lot from a laser. So there must be more to it than just power. And there is. Let's look at the surface power density, measured in watts per square meter, for the two light sources. The LED lamp emits its light from a large surface. The area is around 94 square centimeters on this one. At an output of 1.2 optical watts, that equals an average surface power density of 128 watts per square meter. At just 5 centimeters distance, the light is diffused all around the lamp, spread out to a spherical area of 804 square centimeters. So at a short distance, the average power density has dropped to 15 watts per square meter. No need for safety glasses when using this light source. Now, how about the laser? It emits light in a narrow beam, not 360 degrees all around. The beam from a blue laser diode typically has an area of 4x2 millimeters, with 5.7 optical watts crammed into 0.08 square centimeters. That equals over 700,000 watts per square meter. Truly impressive. But it gets better. At 5 centimeters distance, the beam is focused down to a tiny spot. At the focal point, the average surface power density is 475 million watts per square meter. It's hard to grasp or explain how much that is. So let me just show in a music montage what this kind of power density will do. This is the crazy difference between a 5-watt laser and a 5-watt LED. With a 5-watt laser, you can engrave on rock. Try that with a 5-watt LED lamp. However, despite its inferior power, this lamp does have one advantage. After a short message, I will demonstrate it. Thanks to all my generous patrons. Your help with getting the laser pyrometer and spectrometer makes videos like this one possible. If you want to help me keep going with the videos too, you can sign up on Patreon. Link in the description. Thank you. The LED lamp does have an advantage over the laser. Lumens. The by humans perceived power of light. If we look at the spectrum of light coming from the LED lamp, we can tell that it emits a wide range of wavelengths, a whole rainbow of colors. The lamp contains blue LEDs centered around 460 nanometers that are coated with a phosphor that fluoresces in a wide range of colors. This is clearly a warm white LED since the majority of the light is coming from the phosphor as an orange-red color centered around 600 nanometers. All of this light output combined has a luminous power of 470 lumens. They are kind enough to write it right on the box. 470 lumens is enough to light a small room. Not brightly, but cozily. The laser has more optical power output, but how does it compare for lighting a room? How many lumens does it have? I will use the method I showed in a previous video to calculate it. We know it is emitting 5.7 watts, but not its spectrum. Well, it should be a very narrow spectrum around one wavelength, 450 nanometers. Let's check it in the low-powered focus mode. That looks about right, 449 nanometers at low power. At full power, it would likely heat up and get a slightly longer wavelength. Let's round it to 450 nanometers. At this wavelength and power, it all adds up to a luminous power of 253 lumens, significantly lower than the LED lamp, simply because our eyes are not really that sensitive to blue light. To our eyes, the perceived power of the light from the laser is lower, even though in reality it is much stronger. Yet another reason to wear laser safety goggles. If you want to light a room, a strong laser is not the right choice. The LED lamp is still the better choice for this, as it was designed for. If you want to engrave or even cut stuff, you can use a strong laser engraver. More info on this model in the link in the description. Alright, we now know that a 5 watt light source is a very broad term. It is important to know if the wattage is for electrical or optical power, input or output, the colors of the light, and especially the power density. These details make a crazy difference. Click like if you enjoyed the video enough to watch this far. Oh, and if you want to send me something, I've changed my PO box address. The Danish Postal Service decided that the facility I was using no longer could handle packages, only letters. Who wants a PO box for only letters? So I changed facility. You can always find my latest address and email if you click on my channel name and go to the About tab. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.